Okay, so today we will focus on topic 5. Topic 5 is about object-oriented programming, part 1. Okay, how many of you missed the first tutorial? Okay, me one, two. Okay, namanya. Okay, so last discussion, we were focusing on topic 1 to topic 4. Okay, so during that discussion, I used one example. One example on marks. Yes, marks. Where you use an array to capture the marks, then you do some calculation and display the output. And it was all the programs. I mean, the codes were written using structured approach, similar to C programming, where you dump everything in main. And like C, when you write program in C, you dump everything in the main method. Okay, so the same approach we used in the last discussion, where all the codes you dump in main method. Okay, so that is structured programming. Okay, I call it structured programming because why? Because you didn't create object. You never specify the class. Okay, okay. The difference between C programming and Java programming is that in Java programming you have class. Then from that class you can create objects. All this you don't see in, I mean you don't have in C programming. Okay, that's a difference. In C, you cannot create class, you cannot create object. Okay, you only can write program in a structured way. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, you dump everything in main method. Of course, the same technique can be used in Java, as we discussed in the last tutorial. Okay, but that is not an effective way to write Java program. Okay, because if you want to write an effective or good Java program, you should use object and class. Sorry, class and object approach. Okay. And in fact, object-oriented programming is the focus of this subject, not structured programming. Okay, but of course, you need to know the basic before you can move to more advanced concept of class and object. Because this subject is about object-oriented programming, not structured programming. Okay, so any questions so far before I discuss or before I focus on class and object? Okay, so the subject is object-oriented programming using Java. But before you can create the object, you need to have what? What you need to have before you can create the object? Class. Okay? You need to have class before you can create the object. If you don't have the class, then you cannot create the object. Okay? So in fact, object is more important than class. Okay, even though here the subject is object-oriented programming, it is not known as class-oriented programming, but in order to have the object, you must create the class. And then once you have the class, you can create objects from that class. How many objects you can create from a class? Let's say you have class X. How many objects that can be created from a class? How many? How many you can create? One or two or many? Many, unlimited. As long as your computer, the memory of your computer can support the objects, you can have unlimited. Okay, so what's the difference between object and class? You know object is created from class, right? But what's the difference between object and class? Okay, what's the difference? Anyone? Anyone can give the answer. Okay, what's the difference between object and class? Okay, one difference is that class is the template, okay, that enables you to create the object. Okay, means if you don't have the class, you cannot create the object. Okay, let's say I give you one example in a simple analogy. Okay, this is module. Okay. I will call it as a class because this is the original copy. And once you make photocopies from this main copy, all these photocopies are objects. The original copy is the class. So So from one class, this is one class, okay, you can have many objects. Okay? Okay, another example, when architect build a house, what they need to prepare first? The plan. The plan, right? Plan is the class. Okay, from one plan, from that one class, the architect can create or can build how many houses? One, two, many houses. So the houses are the objects and the plan. The drawing, everything is the class. So class is the template, and from the template you can have the objects. Okay, that is in a very simple analogy. What else? You can give example. Like car, okay, like proton, car. So normally all the drawings is on paper, right? And from that drawing, they can have many physical cars. So all the physical cars are the objects. The one on the drawing is class. Okay, so now you know, in order to have object, you must have the class. Okay, if you don't have the class, you cannot have the object. Okay, so that's the difference between object and class. So class is the main template, the specification, okay, that enables you to, what you call, to create the objects. Okay, a more formal definition is given in the module. So you can read. For the exam, you don't give example like this, like, you know, architect, the plan and house. Okay, for the exam, if they ask what's different between object or class, or if they ask you to define what is class, then you give a more formal definition as given in the book. Okay, basically class is the main template. Okay, that enables you to create object. But you should remember, class does not exist by itself. Okay, what are the components that make up a class? What are the components that make up a class? Because when I say class, it doesn't exist by itself. You need to have, certain components. Okay. So what are the components? Is that in your module, topic 5? There are 3 components that make up a class. Okay, you can see on the slide. The one highlighted in red, class name, attributes, and methods. But this is in the programming perspective, okay? Okay, normally the components that make up a class are 3, the identity of the class, in programming, it is the class name, okay? The second is attributes, okay? Attributes is what? The state of that class, the state. For example, if you have student, class student, can you give some example of the state of the student? Age, name, address are the state of the student. State is the static part of that class. For example, okay, if you have car, what are the states of car? Yes, the model, year, manufactured, what else? Okay, the type of the car, okay? So you have the identity represented by the class name, you have the state represented by the attributes. Okay, you know what is attributes? Attributes is just a variable declaration. Okay, just a variable. But when you declare a variable inside the class to what you call to represent the state of that class, it is known as attribute. So it's not something new. Okay, actually attribute is a variable declaration to represent the state of that class. Okay, the last one, of course, is method. Okay, but method is from programming perspective. But in a real-world kind of analogy, method is what? Operation or the behavior of the class. Okay, if you have class student, what is the, you know, the state is age, name, address, and so on. What is the behavior of class student? Pardon? Read. Read, not so accurate. The behavior of the student is what? Register subject, register semester, pay fees, drop course, add courses. These are the behaviors that can be performed by a student. Okay? Understand? So, okay, how many, if you have a class, doesn't matter whether it is a class car, class building, or class student, how many behaviors that you can have? or how many behaviors, how many operations. It can be, doesn't matter, certain book they use operation, certain book they use behavior. Okay, all the meaning is the same. Okay, so let's say if you have a class student, how many behaviors you can have? Let's say you want to write a class student, how many behaviors you need to put here? 10, 1, 20? It depends on the nature of the problem that you want to solve. Okay, you can have, or you could have 5 methods, you could have 10, or you could have 1 or 0. Okay, it depends on the problem that you want to solve. How many attributes that you need to have in a class? How many? Again, it depends on the nature of the problem that you want to solve. You can have, let's say, only 3, age, name, and address. Or you could have 4 or 5. It depends on the problem that you want to solve. Okay? Class name, no problem. If you are dealing with student, you just write here, class student. Don't put other name that doesn't give you any meaning. For example, if you are dealing with class student, don't put class car. Of course, you can compile, you won't get any error, but in terms of meaning, it's not so accurate. Eh? So class name, I think shouldn't be a problem. You can give any meaningful name. Attributes is the state of that class. And finally, methods. Methods are the behavior or the operation that can be performed by the class. You know what is method? Sorry, I forgot to explain. You know attributes, variable. Methods, what? In C, it is known as function. You know function in C? In Java, we have function, but we call it method. We don't call it function. Eh? It's just matter of name. Okay? In Pascal, they call it procedure. Okay? But in Java, we call it methods. Actually, it's a function. Okay? So you know, this curly bracket is closing for this one. Okay, this is the structure of a class. Okay, I won't talk about object at the moment. Eh? Object, I will discuss later. You know why? Because you need to understand the class. Okay, the structure of the class. Once you understand, you know the concept, well, then only I will discuss about object. Okay, I give you one example of complete class program. Eh? Okay, so, okay, this is an example of class book. Okay, there are a few attributes here. How many attributes are there? How many attributes? Three, yeah? Book title, writer, ISBN number. You know this is integer, this is string, this is string. Yeah? Okay, don't worry about this private. I will explain later. So actually this is attributes. Yeah? Actually attribute is a variable. You just declare a variable to represent the state of this class. The class name is book. All these are methods. This is the first method. Okay, don't worry, yeah, because sometimes you might confuse why the name of the class and the name of this method are the same. Okay, I will explain later. This is a method, first method. Okay, what is the name of the second method? Show title, and then show writer, show ISBN. Huh? Okay, so we have how many methods? 4, right? 4 methods. Okay, these are the 4 methods available in this class book. Eh? This is one, this is second, third one, and this is the fourth one. Eh? And up there you have the states. Okay, so you can see here, books, you can have so many attributes. But here we only declare 3. Eh? Book title, the writer of this book, and the ISBN of this book. Eh? Only 3. You can have 4, you can have 5. But in this problem, we only deal with 3. Okay, so the same goes when you are doing exercise or when you are writing programs. When you are going to define a class, how many states, how many behaviors, it depends on nature of the problem. Okay, so now at least you will have some idea how to write the class for your assignment. Eh? What is the name of the first class? How many classes you need to create for your assignment? 3. The first one is class? Customer. Second class? What? Yeah, Ceras Outlet Customer. And the third one? Okay, now at least you know the meaning of class. Huh? We have, for your assignment, you have 3 classes that you need to create. Huh? And then, what else? And for your assignment, You don't need to worry so much because all the states, all the methods are already given in the question. Means you don't need to think on your own to create the attributes and the operation. Everything is given in your question. Just understand the question and just convert it into a class structure. Okay? So when I said class structure, this is the class structure.